Welcome back. I'm MTG Joe. I'm taking a break from the Constructed because I'm not enjoying tournament play. I like playing the jank, it seems, and just giving myself a break, kind of feeling a little burnt out. So I am coming with another variation of the Abzan Cruel Celebrant, sorry, the Command the Dreadhorde Cruel Celebrant combo deck. So we played a black-white version before. I'm splashing some green this time because it's a good way to fill our graveyard. So to kind of give you an idea of the combo, Command the Dreadhorde lets us return any number of target creatures or planeswalkers from our graveyard to the battlefield. We lose life equal to the converted mana cost. Wanderer, when it's out, makes it so we don't take any damage. So what we want to do is fill our graveyard with cheap creatures that kind of leave bodies behind. You have Hunted Witness or Orzhov Enforcer, and then have all the creatures enter at the same time. You play Massacre Girl, it starts killing off all the creatures, and then you get a bunch of triggers with Cruel Celebrant and Poison Tip Archer, and basically win the game outright. So with adding green, what we get is Glowspore Shaman, which is another way to put cards into our graveyard, and we also get Mausoleum Secrets, which lets us search for either Massacre Girl or Command the Dreadhorde. Vraska can help us draw if we kind of fizzle out and can kind of be removal. And another Poison Tip Archer, which is basically another Cruel Celebrant. I might want... Hunter's Battlefield return target permanent, so this will not get the command back. Let's just see, return target, it's going to be a green card, return card from your graveyard to your hand, so there's recollect, return target permanent, nature spiral, target permanent. Okay, so recollect might be something we want a one of. We'll see after, because if we self-mill all the pieces. But let's try it out, best of one, and see how it goes. This either wins amazingly or kind of plays a bunch of 1-1s. We were playing Jeskai Super Friends. I did not do well, lost every single game, and all the progress I was making with 4-color Dreadhorde fell down. Anyways, positive attitudes going forward. For those of you who are new to the channel, I'm MTG Joe. We play everything from budget brews to jank to tier 1 lists. I usually have between 3 and 7 videos up on YouTube every week. You can check everything that we play up there. If you're enjoying the content, subscribing is a free and easy way to show your support to the channel. And now we also have a Patreon set up, so if you are enjoying the content and are able to throw a couple dollars a month, it goes to help out the channel. Just pays for packs, gems, anything like that, but also just kind of helps offset the cost of running the channel. So anything you can is greatly appreciated. So we'll run with this right now. Glowspore can start filling our hand. We are missing a couple of the combo pieces, but we'll give it a shot. So we'll memorial. Actually, we'll hold off on the memorial. Gonna go temple first. With Memorial, we're going to have to shock ourselves. And it looks like we're going to have a play on 2, and then likely this on 3. This could be Drake's. This could be Mono Blue. This is surprisingly good against the Mono Blue deck. This was a pretty bad flip. Finds a combo piece, is a combo piece. So this is the black-blue Kefnet deck. So usually no counters, but a lot of removal. They take the Poison Tip Archer. Fine racing them here. Flip. Memorial could get back our poison departure if we flood out. So how are you guys doing? Any cool decks you've seen? We finished up our Golgari budget builds. So probably going to go Azorius next, so blue-white, unless there was another color or build around that you were interested. So drop a comment if you haven't seen the series. I do a write-up on Reddit once a week or so, so definitely check it out there. So opponent might have Cryocarnarium. I believe these lists play one main. It's part of the reason I don't like Pteramander in these lists. This forces them to use the removal now. Obviously we're walking into a Ritual of Soot, but this deck also does very little against Cryocarnarium. That out. So decent pressure still on our opponent. The Glowspore is a pretty effective attacker. I got him Kefnet. He's no good. He's no good. 1, 2, 3. So three things die that way. I think we want to do this, get the poison tip archer, and then pass the turn. Poison tip will be one more thing dying, and then it could also pressure Kefnet. They're also somewhat required to hold this back on defense unless they have removal, or they just have Vraska's Contempt and we cry. So we needed that out, and they thought Erasure Massacre Girl. We lost that one. Opponent drew well. This deck's kind of a surprise deck, but when they pick apart our hand like that, it is a little rough. 5 toughness is hard to deal with. We didn't have a lot of the one drops that we normally have. So there, we could have wiped the board, but they would have just, other than the Kefnet, we're left with a 4-4, they have a 4-5. That's drawing an extra card every turn. This hand's not bad. Hunt the Witness, Cruel Celebrant. Playing a turn slow. Unfortunately, probably do Hunted Witness into Glowspore unless we can hit a third land. Probably not the end of the world if they're playing a Dreadhorde deck, because we two are. Yeah, so this is 4-color Dreadhorde. The double Wildgrowth Walker is a little concerning. One damage. So you're gonna go for Shaman. We want more whites. Taxier. Play a Cruel Celebrant out this turn. That is extremely greedy. 4-color deck playing Blast Zone. Smash us for a bunch. We need need to keep out some number of creatures, so I'm just gonna Hunted Witness block. Druid's fine, it just dies. Jade Light's really bad. And Soren. That gains a bunch of life. This is getting to the point too where that's gonna be a bit too much to deal with. So we block here. Aren't helping the cause. They play Soren here, getting a lot of life. We're also losing the ability to have a combo finish. Their life was getting to the point where we're not really doing much. Block like that. I want to keep some bodies around for Masca Girl. So in theory, this is what we're going to do with the deck. It's not been a good day for Magic. We were playing really well yesterday, got a bunch of good wins with Dreadhorde, was having a lot of fun on stream. Today, cannot buy a win. I won the first game with Jeskai Super Friends and then proceeded to lose 5 or 6 straight games, like not even close. So, probably after this stream, we'd go for a nice walk. Haven't really found the deck this season. Dreadhorde's been the closest. Really like Guard. Or Forcer into Midnight Reaper. Try it out. Forcer can hold stuff back. Likely. I think we can win. If they kill something, it draws us a card. Bent. Happier seeing that, to be honest. Do I want the land on top? I think we decline. Just attack in there. It's Bastion. So this is Bant Proliferate. Their sequencing was off, so that probably suggests to me that it's a fairy. Horizons. I like what you're doing, opponent. So here, I'll attack with both. Just want to keep pressuring the opponent. Feel the city's blessing. We can get as big as as it wants, as long as we have Death Touch. Five, six, seven, eight, nine. So they're one off the city's blessing. We have the city's blessing for next turn. So we really hit it into the land, which is great. We hit it. So here. This dies, pretty much wipes everything. I think we just do it. Yeah, let's just do it. We also got a token for this. And we'll draw a ton of Midnight Reaper. Poison Tip Archer. Didn't hit any of the... the little guys. We can Poison Tip and Orzhov Enforcer. Opponent's doing stuff with mana. Lots of it. 6, 7, 8, 9. Omniscience is 10. Magister's Scepter. So the opponent is playing an infinite turn deck. Very cool. Oh. That works out great. So combo next turn. Or close to combo. So Poison Tip. So, how many does this need? That needs 4 to proliferate. So, this gets back. But nothing to really kill. But it does fill the graveyard up quite a bit.
The only companion I know is my blade.
So, we'll just end the turn here. So ideally we want to fill the graveyard, and then it's a two turn. First one is like a setup command. Second one will be a full command. Hopefully we can get back the Sage.
No tail should be discarded.
They're just going to proliferate here. Cool. Ooh. That is interesting. So we could command fill our graveyard. I think that's what we need to do. So we're just gonna kill the Tamio. Put this back in case they start taking.
I have learned
turns.
All I can here.
I'm just gonna get everything back. Oh no, no Midnight Reaper. Midnight Reaper will make us draw out our deck.
Like the phases of the moon, like waxes and wanes.
So just to not mill ourselves out. Okay, so we got another Massacre Girl, so we can win next turn. We need to survive one turn. Or actually, we can return. return the Mossgirl secrets.
The past is never forgotten.
We could command, get back Massacre Girl, and a bunch of other stuff. Or worst case, we can get the combo. So I can start taking some experience. But they need to eventually win. Wilderness Reclamation. That is sweet. But if you give us a turn, you lose. Seems like a lot more convoluted Nexus deck. I appreciate the effort. There's nothing to proliferate. Ah, why would they let us do the turn? We were gonna combo. Alrighty. Back again. Do one more game. Spore Tribal. This is the ultimate of lose to Cryocarnarium. Mines are great. Decline. If we miss a line drop next turn, then we'll put it on top. Shows blue white. Not quite sure what they're on just yet. Still presenting a pretty good clock.
Charge into darkness. Share in my light.
So just attack
you
in
fight
here.
Dirty.
It's pretty good tempo play by the opponent. They could attack into us, but. Even if they settle, it's not the worst for us. Ramps us into a dreadlord turn.
Your light will cleave the dark.
You've never seen anything like
well
this.
Equipped for no blocks.
Curse the darkness!
So here I do want the land. So if they board wipe, we're solid. that's not bad. I'm gonna play out the massacre value here. I can deal with the planeswalker and I kinda want them to kill it. Because that opens us up to command turn.
You have been animated.
I don't enjoy seeing things suffer.
Just
attack, but I'll make
into
an exception
Saheeli.
For you.
Or is off enforcer, not the best.
I need to iterate.
Die. The fact this leaves a body behind is also relevant.
Kings of beauty. I know 88 ways to defeat, meditate, and prepare.
Teferi. I think we still try going after the planeswalkers.
Good
go
assault.
After Narset. Okay, Cruel Celebrant. Yeah, that draws some cards. I don't care about the creatures. Interesting. Is it actually better for us?
The best can't be denied.
For the combo
beaten.
Turn. Yes, we need a land and we win.
Just the trick for this.
We need to be mindful though of life total.
You know what? I'm not done yet.
Plan to absorb. Teferi.
Don't make another move.
See if they want to waste absorb on Hunted Witness. Have we shown a command the dread?
Hurry!
Just like Mask of Hero would be good. Hunted Witness doesn't do much. Teferi's bought them a lot of time.
I won't let you win.
They've drawn a second absorb, but we really just want that land.
We need to move quickly.
Land in a chance. They're drawing so many cards per turn. So they'll start getting angels. Let's see what they got. this point. Doesn't really matter. Double block here. So the flyer is relevant for making angels. Have you known Teferi's still the right thing to get rid of? Of angels shuts us off. Because they're gonna start attacking until our life total will get too low, and we haven't hit Lion, so we can't really wander. Wonder if we want, like, elves, Leyland, or Elves, Ram, but I think that was just, we had like three or four chances. So, part of the combo in hand. Not when you just hit all your lions. Mind you, got through that right. So hoping to get at least something. Jeskai. Could be Jeskai Walkers. Jeskai Artifacts. I like what they're up to. Potentially. Karaska could be good here. Can always fill our graveyard. Sack this, draw a card, hit 3. So commands there. So we have combo and
it's not often I'm outmaneuvered.
Another Stitcher Supply. Vraska uptick and kill the supplier next turn.
I am tough.
A curious choice.
Land.
This will not deter me.
Everyone is expendable.
Sack the Sister Supplier. Take some damage. Spore Shaman. Mausoleum Wander does put the most lands into our grave or Stitcher Supplier. See what the opponent decides here. They can downtick to get the treasure map.
My device is finished.
So I think we need to try to go all out combo as quick as possible. Still have a Karn activation.
Good choice.
Got the treasure map. Guarantees we can land. So we can just get Memorial to Folly.
unfortunate casualty.
Sack the Blue Spore Shaman. Get the land. Yeah, I don't really care if they attack. They're gonna get Clarion. Doctor Tess. So best case next turn. Get the land. And then search up Masker Girl.
The time has come.
So they got Clarion. This actually shuts off Clarion, so we'll see if they want for one here. Top.
I learned a few tricks on Kaladesh.
Here. Do I care if they, okay, so let's attack into Tez first. We get back. We get back Glow Spore, Midnight Reaper, Stitcher Splier. So we get back quite a bit.
As long as we win, nothing else matters.
Just decline there.
I know how this ends.
Just command the Dreadhorde back this turn. Get a Psy, just for the sake of it. And search for Master Girl.
There is great power in the things we make.
Pretty aggressive with their shocking, but I guess they don't know what we have. Masker Girl. Cool. Exile that. Here. Probably.
Sacrifices must be made.
Future Supplier. On the stack. next turn. So hopefully our opponent lets us do it. Opponent gives us the GG.
Recklessness and fear are the seeds of disaster. Your past is unwritten.
So they get rid of that. Don't concede, don't concede, don't concede. Oh, they could Clarion, but they're dead. This is where you kind of lock them in the game. That game was sweet, and that's pretty much how you got to do with the deck. We would have had it anyways with the Massacre Drill. But that's pretty much it. So some tweaking still could probably be done. It's not obviously tier 1. Maybe you want to play some Duress. But overall, it's a fun deck. I enjoy the concept and want to keep playing it. Anyways, thanks for watching. Have a great one. And if you haven't done so already, please make sure to subscribe.